tariko mu kulati sakata bake na tariko lunkane lande ningan na tariko lande mbita wandi tariko letala anu ningo ke du wolon butu wolon nyinti masibo boy tan tolkanne na nunto alfalu ya kata bake ya kata bake inna ado mutale ya kanu inna ya kanu adiyate bake ye ko be kata imonson ay kanema woton dolfana min benta nyin jamano fe bi se ko be kata na ya kana kanamma
Oral history shows a diversity of human experiences and values individual life experiences of the people of all ages and backgrounds. It documents the views and opinions of individuals on a variety of issues, gives voice to marginalized groups often hidden from history, and preserves for posterity unwritten knowledge and individual expertise which would otherwise be lost forever. The history students of the University of The Gambia on Saturday, 19th March 2011, embarked on a research to three original settlements of Kombo, namely Busumbala, Yundum, and Sanya. The students engaged the elders to tell them the history of their respective villages as narrated to them by their ancestors.
The history of Kombo could be conceptualized from the perspective of four main socio-political transformations. The first phase was the establishment of Baynunka dominance in Kombo. The second phase was also the establishment of Manding-speaking migrant of Bojangs and the Jattas. The third phase was the establishment of monarchical-based administration led by Fode Kombosilla. The fourth phase was the establishment of colonial administration in which the entire Kombo area became part of the British protectorate after the overthrow of Fode Kombosilla.
Kombo, as a regional entity, is located in the southwestern Gambia. The ecology in this region was characterized by mangrove swamps behind which laid palm groves. The southwest part of the Kombo also had an ecology which was believed to have possessed numerous bamboo trees and other different species of trees. This beautiful forest attracted the Manding-speaking people of Mali to obtain these bamboo sticks to be used as bows and arrows. The ecology of Kombo thus served as a pull factor that brought many immigrants to settle. Furthermore, political factors in Mali also contributed to their migration into Kombo. It is believed that they came looking for new territories as they lost several of their controlled areas to Sundiata Keita at the Battle of Kirina in 1235. In Kombo, the earliest inhabitants were said to be Baynunkas. The Gambia, Casamas, and Guinea-Bissau were part of vast Baynung Empire called Casa Baynung, with its capital at Brikama, 53 kilometers from present-day Ziguinchor.
Kantu ntolunga mellon dama konton tan saba aninfula si jama ko ne konton jama jabe bay nin kollo tollo man sa folo tim mo fi ngol kono tuba bo le tolle tan man sala ili jije tolle ta ma beti abuluba amara fannao fanna itolle mur be sa bonja itolle men tara nyim banku kanja jielo mu aniro
ni amo nyanyuno bay nin kollo ha bay nin ko nyanyuno
Nyanyuno pepe ufega ndeti mpepe bina nkafonsu jasi chonkodu jauro kuwege udaoda nyanyuno degi
akoli eji kele jauro moe daoda bainu kondo ekelo kele wale mbande ibuka
bote udarama angiala kudu
ikuwa ibuka lafi moe
mara foga gala kudu ufega inara mambichi menkani chile simini
ni aje njanjate muni kelo wale morba
Udara ma, udara lakene, udara mare lakene.
Aku apa kalau semua yang muda, poni yang mau muda debar mote muda lah.
Ani.
Pola nandu yar.
Casa Baynung was ransacked and invaded by Manding migrants under the leadership of Tiramang Trawale. As Donna Wright contends, the wave of Manding migration has altered political geography and ethnicities in Senegambia. Many Baynunkas have changed ethnicity due to Mandinka dominance of both social and political structure. Clearly, certain surnames today, Bondi, Bajinka, Koli, Sambu, and Kombo, are said to be originally Baynunkas. It is established that natives of this region had established civilizations, most of which were acephalous before the Manding conquest. In this region, the Baynunkas established territorial polity in the south coastal settlements of Sanyang, Tujereng, and Kartong, under the matriarchal administrative jurisdiction of Queen Wulending Jesse. Baynunka traces could be identified in terms of the locative term Kang. These villages are found in Funi, believed to be the final destination of Baynunkas when they were subdued by Manding conquerors. Therefore, the nomenclature for settlements like Kang Mamudu, Kang Kuntu, Kang Wali, Kang Sambu, Kang Laji, and Kampanti were all believed to be earlier settlements of Baynunkas. However, in Kombo, most of the earlier settlements were named after the persons who established them. Accordingly, Sanyang was named after a Baynunka man called Sanyang Bajasi. The capital of Kasa Baynung Empire is called Brikama. There are speculations that Brikama, the present-day hub of public administration and commerce in Kombo, is named after that great capital. This is often refuted by Manding versions, despite several divergent versions on the origin of the name of this place. A lot of evidence about the establishment of Kombo seems to point at the fact that the Baynunkas were the earlier settlers in this region.
Janning mobe setula Kombo, sanyan ne folo setulta. Wotu mwana Baynunkol bim bankol khang. Si merim balamit. Violence kelo ebam pare ka jabangol je nyala. Sirin yim bankoka wole Baynunka kelo sabo. Wawato gunjurwe damin bi imantaka nun jeto. Oto be tumbum foloto. Dula dobi je kafo je sandal. Baynunkole be sirin je kafa sandal ba. Between gunjur and nyofele. Wakeno min bi je.
Min du foloto ja. Nika fo le biyarul. Biyarul. Wole foloto ja.
Comme mo xone jam Baynunkol dam male bi yanta si ko tente jam wotuma bojante jatante da bonte sañante si ko tente
ananya bulu o ayayo ananya bulu o ananya bulu o tamundo ananya bulu o
ñu fo ñiarol banko abé jaarol le bulunu jaarol bayni kakunda wolle amal sori sambu anin kaba sambu wolle bara man salaban wolam kabaati wolam kaba sambu.
Migrations are said to be motivated either by pull or push factors. One of the push factors for Manding speaking migrants was ecological. Their original home in Mali was affected by famine and drought. Consequently, the Kontes and Jaras fled towards the west via Kabu. In Kabu, they felt it prudent to establish a political alignment with the then reigning king, Mamba Kotusane. The purpose of this alignment with the king of Kabu was to get military support in case of any eventuality in the Senegambia region. The migration of these Manding-speaking people took two patterns. Those who came passing through the sea in the north bank of the Gambia River were referred to as the Kasinkas, whilst those who passed through the south bank through Foni were referred to as the Karoninkas. The former were referred to as the Kasinkas because they lived with them for some time. The latter were called the Karoninkas because they had intermarried with the people of Karuni in the Casamance region of southern Senegal. The Manding-speaking people wanted to establish their dominance in the whole Kombo. However, the presence of the native Baynunkas posed a threat to their aspirations. Alternatively, they had to seek an external support from the then king of Kabu, Mamba Kotusane. Consequently, Mamba Kotusane sent a military reinforcement and the Baynunkas were forced to retreat, surrender, and finally fled to other areas. This was what paved the way for the total control of the Manding migrants, especially the Bojang and the Jatta clans over Kombo. The Baynunkas deserted their cultural home to establish themselves in the southeastern part of the Gambia and other parts of Kombo. It was these wars that led to their extinction. Therefore, Kombo became the name of this region, referred to in Mandinka as those who are extricated from hostility.
The people there, that particular tribe, Baynunkas, hated them. And the people of Kabu came to help them and then remove that hatred. This is how Kombo came about.
Kombo was born in Baynunka. He was born in Baynunka. He was born in Baynunka. Kombo itolle tarta nyaato e kondano bi ko mbokun dankango wala mo alingata ko mbokun dankoliya biri futati e matembo men e ko min nan kay mukkimi ajaka modon ni kon tol danta jande wala mo fankaso fele tambi dulati je say e ko negela jige do wala mo ngamuru koma kabiri murtinan koma ya bojonkinan kotake ini labangol kabbe nimmin nata te mu shiji malde tolmo ni shikar la homo gutamo e kamuni nyini kanno hode ke tem e kon kashir la la nyini dam min nandine kanno ho dumina guno in tol man shir la dile ta shino la fo ma shir la dile.
The pre-colonial Senegambia is tied into a complex web of socio-cultural alliances called dankuto between states, ethnic groups, people of different patronymic names and cousins. This is a significant bond in the establishment of territorial security and internal stability, sometimes referred to as joking relationships.
Kerana kamu masih kau, ya, ia dosa di dalam ini. Mula saja baru lembas lagi. Oh, dah kau sebab kamu mungkin kau teman saya. Kamu kau nak temul dari kerana kau lina, kerana tuh kan aja kau bayi kau kele, kebun dia kau mungkin sabda. Kau mungkin sabda sendiri ni bayi kau bayi.
The existing evidence regarding the history of Queen Wulanding Jesse is diverse. The oral version states that Queen Wulanding Jesse migrated from Tilibo, or the east in Mali. She passed through Kabu to Karuni. It is confirmed that when she was moving southward to establish a permanent settlement, she stopped at Kumbalulu in Karuni. 3 years later, she consulted the oracle, and it was revealed that she was yet to reach her actual destination. With strong determination to reach the prescribed destination, Queen Jesse followed the riverbank until she got to a place called Bekefete near Sanyang. Queen Wulanding Jesse had 3 daughters from Tilibo, Mali. These daughters were Kutu Jane, Banna Jane, and Kani Jane, as well as other members of her family. At this time, both Tujereng and Kartong were under the jurisdiction of Wulanding Jesse, both situated at Pacholing. It is established that most African settlements frequently resettled in search of fertile land and protection from lawlessness that prevailed at the time. Similarly, for Tujereng and Kartong, as a result of continuous conflict and insecurity, she directed the people of Tujereng to move north-south and settle there forever.
Sanyambe sirin jang, satel minu ba dala, wo jamano la wolemu, katonti katombe nun damin jelon pacholen e kafo je cholen afele sanyan nin tu geren tema wo wato le sany katom mufta kataybe border to damin sany sate min bo dala wala mu fande tinting in those days bor sany kafo je tu geren so mune atin na sate to bota ala to floto ya tola tu geren na because ya jelo ko biri mufta musuman so ko si daming sate be daming sanyin ali tuje fo yereng.
Other sources reveal that the present day Katong was built by Kambi Jesse. His roots can be traced from Mali. Kambi Jesse lived at Abene village in Kasamas before journeying to build Sanyang. It is narrated that Karafayali, a hunter from Busumbala, came to discover the kingdom of Sanyang when he reached the southern part of Kombo on one of his hunting trips. Accordingly, Karafayali climbed on a soto tree while waiting for wild games. He heard cock crow at daybreak and also women pounding in the daytime. This made him to confirm the existence of an established settlement. Consequently, he followed the direction of the sound. Surprisingly, he saw Queen Wulending Jase.
People might actually wonder how a woman from such a background could establish a powerful political influence in Lower Kombo area. The matriarchy has been in existence for many years, as it is actually narrated to us by the elders in all Kombo area. What we need to understand is the political transformation in the Lower Kombo area after the demise and the extinction of Baynunka, or before the extinction of Baynunka. There emerged another powerful Manding-speaking force in the Sanyang area who actually succeeded the political throne of Sanyang and the other area. These were the Jabans, led by Control Jabang, who were the people who actually fought in the Lower Kombo area against the Baynunka dominance. Control and the Jaban dynasty emerged as political leader in the Kombo area before the migration of the Manding-speaking people. In the pre-colonial Senegambia, the main function of the kings and the queens, one is to provide territorial defense and security for their people. The second one is to serve as spiritual leaders, that is, serving as intermediaries between their subjects and the ancestors who passed away before time. It is important that Queen Wulending Jase also served as what spiritual leader for our people. Wulending Jase in that time had a great mystical power that made her people to elect her to actually succeed the father who was called Kambi Jase. Where we are right now, it is the shrine of Queen Wulending Jase. This confirmed and symbolized that our people were inclined to believe in the existence of divine power of God.
It was asserted that the Gambia as a country derived her name from Kambi Jase, Wulending's father. Kambia and Kambi Bolong all depicts the territorial possessions of Kambi Jase. The term Kambia was later corrupted as Gambia. Lot of evidence pointed out that the Baynunkas were the indigenous people of the Kombo. In the pre-colonial Senegambia, alliance systems were not only facilitated in terms of intersocietal, states, or horizontal interrelationship. An abstract form of alignment through vertical interrelationship was facilitated as a strong base to strengthen state powers and political positions against alleged human and spiritual forces. Therefore, the three main sacred ecological settings in Kombo, namely Makasutu, Kartong Folonko and Kachikali, are said to be abode of spirits belonging to the people of various settlements in Kombo. The sacred grove, Kartong Folonko, located on the southwestern part of the Atlantic, was named after Folonko Jase, Kambi Jase's son. Wulending, a sister to Folonko, was left at Sanyang to rule. But what is more authentic is that Sanyang was founded by Kambi Jase well before the arrival of Queen Jase.
Folonko fananata na nyamin. Iko to maya tarebe karonko mutun ko kambani ndingoli tente itata loni no la suto konje biri tata loni no le tata e ke ba taraje iko ndol tata ulumbangot baranga mole taraje ako modu aliya taraminela iko ngakele taraje baran dol nga tarale akajimi akawuli akajimi akawuli ah ika aliya tar salol ndol nga tarla ka fongolod ka fongolo wala ne ko folonko.
Busumbala is located in Upper Kombo, formerly called Afet. The Jata clan is believed to be the founders of Busumbala. They arrived in Kombo around the 13th century. This was shortly after the Battle of Kirina between Sundiata Keita and Sumanguru Konte. The defeat of Sumanguru forced the Konte and Jara clans to move to the western parts of this sub-region.
Manding. kafutan kolle nata nyona anin birkama anin manduare yo kabili nata ifurata kafuta wodole kuro keje je la bayo jaje duwal kon talbe sila jalla ko kafuta jare su dun do la da tambinan usumbala nin birkama nin manduare wona da tambinan usumbala ngol fana da itara si bala tanje ha wol si taw yo bini boto be birkama anin jamburu bojang le molo mo kirimo usumbala ngol mbari ngol lamu be birkama ngol o kamala usumbala mansol mintre ja dana fo mansa tan ali wor
mbe jammindo tentin mbe sulin jata la bun tintingole no kanja bole mu mansalla bawti busumbala nyin sita kurol min bi jantentin jannam busumbala la sate to wotu moy be mansa yala yo nyin duto bala jonkon kara ko male ala jonkon yo bari nyim ala bun tintimo wo man num bole to tentin ate sulin jata yo ate sulin jata ate le man soti mi alon ko ate le labanta busumbala man sayala ja.
It should be noted that during this period of migration from Mali, the village of Sanyang was already in existence and known to be the oldest village in Kombo. This assertion was confirmed by the elders of Busumbala, Yundum, Sanyang, and Manduar.
Busumbala musa te ke babal te komo kono bi sa te chosanola birin nung hani kuoku kombo lafta fola ikana be on fola busumbala jeno busumbala fana sa te min traktori mo ka bota dingol ko sanyang kollem sumala musa nyante do ko fira wona mo lem nung ni nata e ku batu e bi ko do ko mo do ko dingol ko mo meri balu sanyante.
According to the tradition, a lineage-based kingship was established in Busumbala when Karafayali Jata got married to one of the daughters of Queen Wulending Jase. After the consummation of the marriage, Karafa took away his wife from her mother in Sanyang. According to the tradition, it was the lady who surrendered her royalty to her husband in Busumbala. Therefore, the name Busumbala originated from two Mandinka words, Busi, which means to forcibly take away from, and Abala, meaning her mother. The establishment of Busumbala is a testimony that the Manding-speaking people of Busumbala were centralized and wasted no time in establishing a political civilization in their newly established place. The Jattas still remain at the helm of affairs in Busumbala. Busumbala, therefore, had succeeded in establishing a political alignment with both Sanyang and Yundum at a very early stage, which demonstrated the political consciousness of its leadership at that time. Yundum also occupied a unique place in the history of Kombo. The people of Yundum were very instrumental in the administration of Upper Kombo region. They are called Bojang Tamba. They migrated to Yundum due to a dispute over the mystical spear that symbolized their political authority. They are therefore identified as Bojang Tamba. However, it was narrated that when the dispute erupted over the succession, the elders of Bojang clan in Kombo met and decided that the other brother with Tamba Falantown, meaning spear without handle, should migrate to Upper Kombo area. This led to the formation of rotational kingship between Jattas and Bojangs in the Kombo Afet region.
Yundum tofang mu yutaleti. Yuta. Yutata nane nata sijang. Mansam wang anenkiling. Wole tolota yundum sate okano jang. Yenim busumbala laka nyo falim mansayala. Nim mansa tolota yundum jang ala deputy betara busumbala le king in waiting mi yalon ka be ma yabela moy kan ni ni ndom bata jatale bina ni nga atabe mansa yala jana king in waiting betara yundum janne because busumbala mu yundum bari ndingol leti bojangol nin jatal kundan ko la kenya kam.
In the latter part of 19th century, Kombo witnessed the migration of the Muslims from the east. These minority Muslim clerics found the entire Kombo in the hands of Soninke aristocracy. The Muslim clerics established their own separate settlements in Gunjur and Sokoto. However, the non-Muslim aristocrats in Kombo were hostile and forced them to pay annual tax to the reigning kings of Kombo based in Brikama, Busumbala and Yundum. By 1855, the Muslims gradually gained ground in their settlements, mainly Gunjur, Sokoto and Brufut, against the Soninke political hegemony. As a result, Fakeba led the Muslim troops to invade Busumbala, in which Mansa Suling Jata was killed by forces loyal to Fakeba Touray of Gunjur. Mansa Koli Bojang of Kombo was very powerful and despotic. However, all the seven Muslim villages situated along the coast of Kombo became allied to Fode Kombosila. They were Gunjur, Katang, Sanyang, Tujereng, Brufut, Sabiji, and Jambur. The Soninke villages were as many as 19, and they were Brikama, Manduar, Kiti, Sifo, Busumbala, Yundum, Lameng, Mandinari, Tubakuta, Selet, Pirang, Farababanta, Farabasutu, and Kafuta. After the demise of Fakeba, the Muslim elders in Kombo, with strong determination, were eager to elect a leader who will help them to uproot the Soninke hegemony. Consequently, the Muslim elders in Kombo employed the service of marabus, who went into halwa, or spiritual seclusion, for 7 days and recommended Fode Sila as right candidate for the post. The Muslim elders met Fode Kombo Sila Touray at Kanuma. Research has given the university students the opportunity to examine Kombo from different perspectives. That is the socio-political situation before the arrival of Mandinkas, an establishment of Sanyang, Busumbala and Yundum, the coming of Islam and the transformation of Kombo from lineage-based to monarchical-based administration. The story of Queen Wulending Jase demystifies the notions that Africans were entirely patriarchal. It has been established that Baynunkas inhabited Kombo before the arrival of the Manding-speaking people. Baynunka Kombo is believed to be part of the Greater Kasa-Baynung Empire that encompassed greater parts of the present-day Gambia, Kasamas, and Guinea-Bissau. However, today, very little is known about this humble ethnic group, their language, and origin.